Hey folks, Rick here from LaLa Farm. So anyone who's watched our channel for a little while knows that we've got a decent size chicken flock between two coops. Well, generally we will treat in the fall for a gut disease called coccidiosis. I didn't do that this year, just got too busy. So we're gonna do that treatment today. So let's go treating. So obviously, if you manage chickens, whether that be for eggs or for meat, you want to try to keep that flock as healthy as you can. Whether you're growing them for meat, you want them to be able to grow out as quickly as possible. If you're raising them for eggs, then you want to keep their egg productivity as high as possible. So good chicken management, health management, is a really important part for managing a chicken flock, particularly one the size of ours. We have about 90 chickens split between two coops. So generally, as we come out of the summer season and move into the fall, temperatures begin to drop. What happens is that the temperatures in the environment around these chicken coops begins to become ideal for a chicken gut disease called coccidiosis. Coccidiosis is a very common poultry parasite that attaches itself to the inner lining of the chicken's intestinal wall. A coccidiosis infection, for lack of a better word, can cause significant problems with your flock. Individual birds is what it generally affects. But once one is affected, most likely speaking, all the rest of your flock has been exposed, and they may have various levels of immunity to that, or resistance to the coccidiosis disease. So that's why when the need for treatment arises, you treat the entire flock. So how does coccidiosis, how does it begin? How does it take hold within a poultry flock? It starts as a microscopic egg. Now every chicken has some strain, one of many strains of coccidiosis. So the whole infection process starts by the chicken depositing the coccidiosis egg into the soil through its droppings. The microscopic egg that's laid, it's then in the soil, does really not become problematic. It can lay dormant for up to a year until the conditions, the environmental conditions, are optimal for that egg to hatch out. So it really doesn't become a threat to your flock until the conditions evolve to be optimal around the area, mainly the eating area and the watering area where your chickens are. Optimal conditions occur in wet, humid, and moderate temperatures between 70 and 90 degrees over several days would constitute the optimal conditions for this disease to kind of take hold. So when the egg is exposed to these ideal conditions for several days, the egg begins to develop, or a process called sporulation. Scientific term, it just basically means that the egg begins to develop within the environment where it has been deposited. Once that egg begins to develop, then chickens, whether that be through pecking at the ground, whether that be through scratching at the ground, will ingest that egg. When that parasitic egg is ingested, then it begins to multiply very, very rapidly and invades the lining of the small intestine of the chicken very, very quickly. So like I said previously, all chickens carry some level of coccidiosis. So it's really not an issue of eliminating coccidiosis. This is something that is prominent in cattle, it's prominent in goats, and it's particularly prominent in poultry. So it's not something that you're trying to eliminate, because it's really not possible to eliminate it. It's the chickens naturally carry it. What varies from chicken to chicken is what their level of resistance is to the impact of the strain of coccidiosis that that chicken carries. Maybe it's multiple strains, but if they have a good resistance built up, then it becomes less of an issue to that chicken, because they're able to fight the parasite off naturally without any outside intervention. That's why coccidiosis is particularly problematic for younger chicks, up to three, four, 5 months old, because they are just developing that immunity or that resistance to the environment in which they're being raised. But in some instances, again, because all chickens carry this disease, adult chickens, it's prominent in adult chickens as well, but by that time, ideally, they have resisted it because they've developed that tolerance within their body systems. So this year, we have developed a problem. We put in, I want to say 100 birds last fall, and those birds are still in their, at this point they're about 9 months old, and in the last 2 weeks we've began to notice some very liquidy droppings in the barn, in the back barn, and we've had three chickens die. Just one day they looked to be fine, the next day they're dead. Really without any signs that anything was wrong with them. So what are the symptoms? Independent birds, or each independent bird, has its own level of coccidiosis resistance. You can call it immunity if you will, but it's the level of resistance that individual bird has in fighting off that parasite invasion. So when a bird ingests that coccidiosis egg, if they're not able to fight it, you're gonna see symptoms evolve usually in the first 4 to 7, 4 to 8 days or so. What symptoms are you looking for? As I mentioned earlier, the symptom that we've had is that one is just really, really kind of a liquidy dropping. And second, obviously it's too late, they just die. But other things that you can look at is weakness or lethargy. They're just not, chickens, if you're a chicken tender, I like that term, if you're a chicken tender, you kind of know what your chicken's behavior is from day to day. You know how they act. Some of them are flighty, some aren't flighty. Some will walk right up to you, some are gonna avoid you, like it's their last day on earth. So you know what to expect from your own chicken flock because you're around them all the time. So if that behavior begins to change, they start showing signs of lethargy, or they're just generalized weakness. For example, if you've got a bird that is just sitting in one place and isn't bothering to eat, that's what I'm talking about, is lethargy, lack of activity. Another one is a pale comb or skin. Now skin is hard to see because you've got the feather coat, but the comb is much easier to see, the paleness in that comb. Now that's not a dead-on sign, because some birds naturally don't have bright red combs, particularly in the wintertime, because the protein sources are lower. I mean, you'll see really brilliant combs in the summertime. Also around the vent. Now, if you don't know what the vent is the hole where the egg is laid out. It's also where the bird poops from. So blood around that area is another potential sign of coccidiosis. No one of these signs is an absolute sign of coccidiosis, but when you start putting one and one and one together, you got six, that's a good sign that you might want to consider treating your flock for coccidiosis. Again, if one bird has it, there's a good chance that all of your birds have been exposed. Treatment is relatively simple and straightforward and rather inexpensive. We're going to cover that in a bit. So another sign is decreased food consumption or water consumption. They're just not eating, or they're not going to the waterer. Another one is ruffled feathers. A good healthy chicken is going to have a very smooth coat on them. They're not going to, their feathers aren't going to be all over the place, with the exception of when they're in molt. We've got some right now. I think I posted one of my short videos a few weeks ago, the mutant chicken. This is the time of the season when many of those breeds of birds are molting. And so they may have ruffled feathers. So again, no one of these signs is a dead ringer that you've got coccidiosis. But again, putting all of these symptoms together, would be a better indicator. Weight loss, particularly in older chickens. If you've got a good meaty bird that's been producing for a few years and all of a sudden they start losing weight, and it's hard to tell unless you pick up that chicken and hold them and you can kind of feel how that chicken, how meaty they are. If you can feel the breastbone, for example, and it's a good meaty bird, you can feel the breastbone, but you're also going to feel meat on both sides. When they start losing weight, that's one of the first areas where they start losing weight, is down in their underside, particularly around the breastbone. Another sign is they stop laying eggs consistently. Now, we have a significant drop-off every winter. Shorter days, colder temperatures. So I kind of expect that, but we also treat for this coccidiosis. Again, I'm doing it later than I like to generally. I want to generally do it in the late spring and early fall as they're coming out of the summer when those temperatures begin to come down is generally when I would want to do this. So granted, I'm a little bit late this year doing this. Just probably should have been done early October or so. That treatment is very effective, but it again involves treating every single bird in your flock. Generally the easiest way to do that, now if you've got a bird that's gone way too far, that's really lethargic, not moving, not eating, not drinking, it may be too late, but you can try to treat that bird individually with the treatment that we're going to talk about in a second. But generally speaking, if you do this on a maintenance level, this is done as a flock-based treatment through their watering systems. All right, so this is the product that we're going to be using today. This is CORID Amprolium, and I purchased this on Amazon. This is not something that is controlled. You don't have to go through your vet. I got this on Amazon. You can get it through Tractor Supply, but they don't generally carry it, or at least they don't carry it in our store. You can get it through them, or you can get it through Amazon. I'm gonna leave a link to the product up at the top in this video that's available through our affiliate link. It's ideal that once this is administered to your chicken that they can begin showing signs of improvement. Again, this is going to be administered through their water source, which we've just cleaned out recently. Ideally, they're going to begin showing signs of improvement if they're showing any of those lethargy, the loose stool, not eating, not drinking, within 24 hours. So it reacts very, very quickly, because once the medication gets into their own intestinal tract, it keeps the parasitic invasion or the parasitic infestation from multiplying any further. It just inhibits it. So they show improvement relatively quick. So this is a 10 ounce package of Amprolium. That 10 ounce package will treat up to 125 gallons of water. And so that's what we're gonna do now, is we're going to basically put this into our two watering systems. I'm gonna keep this one on camera. We're up at the front coop right now, so we got about 20 chickens up here. So we're gonna treat this water, the other one works just like it. So let's get at it. What we're gonna do, the mix is 4 ounces per 55 gallons. So that's what we're gonna do. I've got my There's 4 ounces. Now we could dump this directly into the water. I don't like to do that. I like to dissolve it in water before I pour it in. So that's what we're gonna do. We're just going to dissolve it first and then pour it right into the barrel, and then I'll just take off the water catchment system so that I'm not putting more water into this barrel, so we're not diluting it. And I'll just monitor the water level over the next week to make sure that, I'll just put this behind it, to make sure that this water, that they're getting the whole dose. Again, 4 ounces. I'm gonna leave that off, and then once we go through 7 days, then I'll put the And I'll put the water catchment back on, and then we will go on with life. So there you have it. So this is the preventative treatment. In this case, I think we're an active, it's an active treatment because we are, I know we've already got some birds that are showing some signs of coccidiosis. So generally this is preventative. I just didn't do it in the fall. So we've lost a few chickens this year, and we've got some signs that it's prevalent in some of the birds in the back coop. So I'm going to do both coops because the coops, again, we free range everything. So our birds are not confined at all. They can walk the entire property. So because of that, they can swap between coops. So that's why we're treating both coops today. Even though we don't have any active symptoms up front here, we're doing both. So I hope you found this information informative. We try really hard to bring content that is not only educational and informative, but also entertaining. If you like the content, make sure to subscribe to the channel, ring that notification bell, and give us a big thumbs up if you liked it. Remember, folks, always treat others as you would like to be treated. Be well, my friends.